Batman? Superman? What about Deadpool? Here's Jimmy Johnson's 2016 Lowe's Superman Chevrolet SS. Howdy, howdy, folks. It is Diecast Buffet here again. And, well, I tell you what, we got a banging look at Diecast here in the studio today. And this is, I tell you what, for all the Jimmy Johnson fans out there, this might be a little bit of a nostalgia trip. Think about it. This car was ran at the 2016 Auto Club 400 when this cat went to victory lane. Now, my memory doesn't always help me out here, but I'm not sure if they made a raced version of this car. This is the clean version, so if they made a raced version, then please feel free to let me know. I remember picking up this car for Christmas back in the day, and I tell you what, man, this is an incredible paint scheme, and it's part of a promotion that Jimmy Johnson did. It was Batman versus Superman, okay, which is back in those days, it was a big deal, right? Dale Jr. ran the Batman car, because I don't know why, but he likes Batman, which is cool, man, it's cool. Jimmy Johnson, who's kind of been known as Superman, it's kind of one of his little nicknames they've kind of given him. He drove this car, and he freaking won it. My favorite part here, how the Superman arm kind of has a three-dimensional pattern, and it goes to the top of the box here above the car. Incredible. And even the box on the bottom actually looks great. I mean, look at that. That is just incredible detail that Lionel Racing was able to get here. Got, of course, you know, the Warner Brothers and all that good jazz. But I tell you what, man, absolutely stunning box design. How's the diecast look? Let's go ahead and get it right out of the box, folks. Alrighty, folks. Right out of that good old box. And I tell you what, man, this is one of the most detailed Jimmy Johnson cars you will ever see. I mean, this entire paint scheme has nothing but detail, texture, and just absolute awesomeness. Now, they could have went with a plain Jane white car or made it all just one shade of blue, put a Superman logo on the corner panel, whatever. No, they went all out for this paint scheme. They even put a shadow effect on the actual white parts of the car with the Lowe's and the 48 and all that good stuff. They didn't just put a plain Jane white 48. No, they put texture to it. That is when you have these big movie production cats. They want their merchandise to be the best thing on the market, right? They don't want nothing that you could pick up at the dollar store. They want something that is just completely unique. They want something that's super detailed. And I tell you what, man, to get this in a 1/64 scale fashion, and for it to look this freaking good, absolutely amazing job by Lionel Racing. So you go here to the hood of the car, you got the Superman chest badge right there, very sharp. Of course, you got the Johnson logo right there. On the front windshield, you got the Chevrolet SS logo right there. You got the, I'm not sure what this is, it's like his eyes or maybe his fists or something, I don't know. But that's really cool. I got the Hendrick Motorsports decal. It's literally like glaring. You know, looking back at it, this would probably be considered a meme with the red glowing eyes. Oh, boy. So you got the 48 right there. Very sharp, fine, and dandy. You got Moog, Mail, Comp, Edelbrock, Sunoco. Got the yellow splitter down below. Very nice. Go over to the left side of the car. I mean, just look how beautiful this diecast is, man. Good God almighty, man. I think cats who ain't even a superhero type of person would even like this paint scheme. I mean, you have the red kind of cape that kind of goes across where the A-pillar is. It just shoots through, and it has, like, instead of it just being, like, just a red, you know, cape, no, it's like a nice dark maroon with the shades and the ripple effect. I tell you, when they designed this car, they went to work, I will say. You got Jimmy Johnson right there with the social media tags. And, of course, if you want to go ahead and follow me on Instagram, feel free down below. I have a link to that. Of course, you got Hendrick Motorsports, Exalta. Of course, you got Bosch, Freightliner, Simeons. And it also helps to give the video a big thumbs up as well. You got Valvoline there. You got Lowe's, a little bit of a decal crinkle there. Of course, this is back in 2016, but this is one of the hottest diecast of that season. I love this thing. I absolutely love this. This is kind of a small tribute to the Lowe's red vest car that he ran a couple times. I know he ran it once at Texas and he won it, but I don't know if he ran it again. But you got the Lowe's SS right there. You got the 48 Chevrolet. You got, of course, the Valvoline logo right there. And got those four exhaust panels back there with the two on the side. But notice how the cape is dark on the top, but it kind of, you know, turns into a very nice red on the back end. I gotta say, that color, I mean, just look how beautiful that shade of red is. I mean, I could drive a car with that. I mean, it's just that absolute beautiful. And, you know, growing up a Jimmy Johnson fan, I was not the most super Jimmy Johnson fan because I was a Dale Jr. cat, and I was like, Man, why does Jimmy Johnson win all these races? Can he let Earnhardt win once or twice? But absolutely, man. He was the driver of my generation. And wow, man. This guy is just a living legend. I mean, he is a living legend amongst us. You know, the guys who say, oh, man, I wish I seen Earnhardt race, or I wish I seen Petty race. Jimmy Johnson is here in the flesh. He's racing. Go enjoy it while you can. I'm going to try to see him one last time. I tell you, man, go enjoy it, because he ain't going to be racing forever. And then you're going to hold on to those memories and look back and say, man, I'm really glad I got to see a 7-time champion driving that 48 car. It's something we may never, ever get the opportunity to see again in NASCAR. So go over here to the roof. You got the 48 right there. And I mean, just look at this detail here, guys. I mean, just check this out. I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to get all that good, fancy lighting. It's literally just some cheap lights now. These lights weren't cheap, but you got the point. So you got the 48 right there. And just look at that pattern. I mean, it looks kind of like an old-fashioned wallpaper that's kind of got, like, you know, like those, like, wallpapers that kind of yellow over time. Maybe they had a bunch of smokers at the hotel. That's what it looks like. But I tell you what, it's absolutely beautiful, though. Stunning. And then you got the Lowe's logo that even has that as well. I mean, just beautiful. I mean, the cape, the blue. I mean, this is a stunning diecast. And I don't think I've ever seen a diecast with this much level of detail, like actual, like, texture detail. Remarkable job here by Lionel Racing and Hendrick Motorsports, and of course everyone involved on the production side for the film. I mean, thank God they actually wanted to do this sponsorship, and then thank God they actually allowed them to make a diecast of it. Because, you know, just because they sponsor a race car, some of these companies, in my opinion, are dumb enough that they turn down Lionel Racing and these other companies or whatever to produce a diecast. Imagine paying millions of dollars or hundreds of thousands or whatever to sponsor a race car, a big name driver, and then saying, oh, we don't want diecast of it. It's just stupid, you know? I mean, you're sponsoring the guy, right? So you want all the brand exposure you can get. And then you tell these companies, oh, no, we don't want to have a diecast made or anything. It's just stupid. But luckily, these cats aren't stupid. Of course, the Batman and the Superman logo combined right there. Kind of hard to read with the deck a little bit dark maroon. But I tell you, man, this is one of the most incredible Jimmy Johnson diecasts ever made. And it's just stunning. Now, I don't know how many they made of these cars. They probably made a crap load, to be honest with you, because they probably sold these at, I wouldn't be surprised if they sold them at little nerd shops and stuff, because I love little nerd shops, like a Second and Charles. I wouldn't be surprised if they had this with the other Superman and Batman stuff when that movie was still trending. But I tell you what, man, stunning diecast. If you're a Jimmy Johnson cat, if you're not a Jimmy Johnson cat, I think this is a paint scheme for everyone. It's the special superhero car. In my opinion, probably the most textured paint scheme I've ever seen on a 1/64 scale diecast. And this guy won in this paint scheme as well. So that just makes it just the complete package. And of course, it's just incredible. And thank the good Lord above, they produced it on this car and not the horrid PTC. Because if that happened, oh my God. You know how bad this car would be if they produced it on the PTC with this texture? This thing would look like hot garbage, man. It would look like a waste management truck backing up to your front drive. I mean, good God. Anyways, folks, thank y'all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me what y'all think about this 2016 Lowe's Superman, whatever you want to call it, car. The official name for it, if you could see it, is Lowe's Superman. Pretty cool. Chevrolet. For Jimmy Johnson, at that time, he was 6-time. Just kidding. He won the championship in 2016, so it's even better to get this car. Have a great one, folks. Like, comment, subscribe, and stay humble. God bless. Diecast Buffet, signing off.